Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I am so excited for today's video because I'm going to be sharing 5 life-changing books that I feel are must-reads for all aspects of your life. Reading is so magical for me because if you think about it, the world is so huge and there's so much for us to learn, so much more than we can even fit in one lifetime. But reading helps us to acquire that knowledge and wisdom and expand our minds more and more with each book that we read. It's very easy for us to get caught up in our environment, our day-to-day, being glued to the TV, to our phones, and reading just gets us out of our bubble and really opens up our mind to what else is out there. There's so much more out there. So if you want to know what 5 books I'm talking about, then you're going to want to keep on watching. But very quickly, if you are watching this video and you're not subscribed yet, please go ahead and subscribe by clicking the button below and also hitting that notification bell so you're actually notified the next time I upload a video. And without further ado, let's get into the video. Okay, so as you can see, I have all of the books that I'm going to be mentioning today here with me, and we're going to get started with my favorite book of all time, which if you've seen my positivity video that I posted a few months back, then you already know how I feel about this book. I am obsessed with it, and it is The Untethered Soul by Michael A. Singer. I will say that you have to be ready to read this book in order to truly appreciate it. This is the first self-help / spirituality book that I've ever read, and the perfect one. The author explains the power of the mind in such a way that's so easy to understand and grasp, but at the same time, it's so eye-opening. So he starts by walking through your relationship with your thoughts, helping you get to the source, and then he goes into helping you figure out what you can do about these thought patterns that you formed in order to free yourself from the limitations that they create. He explains that there are 2 versions of you, the first being yourself, which is pure stream of consciousness, and the second being your ego, which is the identity you form. And being able to separate yourself from your ego is what true freedom and inner peace looks like. So that's like a very, very brief little summary on what the book is, but trust me, you're not going to want to put this book down once you pick it up. It is life-changing. It changed my life. It changed my mindset on life. Once you're done, you will never look at yourself or your life the same way again. I promise. Okay, so the second book I want to mention in this video is The Alchemist by Paolo Coelho. And holy mother, this book is everything. A true, true treasure. So for another brief little synopsis, this book takes place way back when, and it's about an Egyptian shepherd boy who has this recurring dream of finding a hidden treasure near the Egyptian pyramids, and he sets out on a journey to find it and to follow that dream, basically. And in his journey, he discovers his purpose, his destiny, which the author explains is man's only obligation. His journey teaches us about the wisdom of listening to our hearts and recognizing opportunities, learning to read signs along our path, and most importantly, following our dreams. I am not lying to you when I tell you that there were so many points throughout reading this book where I just caught myself smiling. That's how heartwarming it is. It's broken New York Times best-selling records, and it is a must-have. Third book I want to mention is The Secret by Rhonda Byrne, and I am very big on the law of attraction, and this is the first book that I actually read on the law of attraction. Actually, first I saw the documentary on Netflix, and then I went ahead and read the book, which the book is way better than the documentary, as is usually the case. But if you're just getting started learning about the law of attraction, I would really recommend to first go watch the documentary on Netflix and then pick up this book. So this book explains the law of attraction in all areas of your life, from finances to relationships to health. It's a great book to start with. So the law of attraction basically states that like attracts like. What you think and feel determines what you attract into your life, because thoughts influence your actions and the experiences that you bring into your life. You'll find this concept touched upon in a lot of older self-help books, but this book just kind of ties everything together into one book, and it's very easy to understand. I just love it. It's controversial, of course, like many great things are. You're gonna have people who hate it, and you're gonna have people who love it, and some people who are kind of in between, who sort of agree with some aspects but don't really understand or agree with other aspects. I say don't knock it till you try it, because it's life-changing. Okay, the fourth book I want to mention is You Are a Badass by Jen Sincero. Oh my god, like, I cannot say enough about this book. This book is the book that really not only shifted my mindset, but really made me take, like, really massive action. Jen Sincero is just, like, queen. I love her approach to self-help. It's like that best friend that's very straightforward, you know, no nonsense, very honest, will tell you like it is, but also very humorous at the same time. She's gonna make you feel really, really empowered, like a badass, while at the same time literally making you pee your pants as you read this book. Through this book, she inspires you to take control of your life. Cut the excuses, cut the crap, screw the fears, and, you know, just do. This book is all about conquering self-doubt and living up to your standards instead of trying to conform or hold yourself back. I also love it because she gives examples from her own life, so it's not preachy. Again, it's very relatable. She's very easy to connect with. You're not gonna want to put this down. It's like an addictive Netflix series that you want to binge on, but better. Okay, and the last book that I'm going to mention in this video is The Four Agreements by Miguel, Ruiz. It's a really short book, it's a really quick read, but it's so powerful, because ultimately these four agreements that he speaks about in the book have a lot of power over you and how you live your life, your quality of life. So for example, one of the agreements is don't take anything personally, and when you hear that, it's kind of like, okay, I know this, I've heard this 1,000 times, and I even know I shouldn't do this or I shouldn't think this way, but the way the author explains it and goes into it really makes you understand why you shouldn't. This book is really more of a guide than anything else, because the principles in this book are meant to be practiced, so it's important to keep referring back to them every now and again, refreshing your memory and kind of evaluating where you are. Okay, so those are the books I wanted to mention in this video. Comment down below if you've read any of them and what you thought about them. And if you haven't read them, I will have them all linked in my description so you can check them out. I also want to make this kind of into like a little series where I can come, you know, every few months with some new recommendations for you guys, and we can kind of talk about them in the comments. I think that'll be a lot of fun. So I need help coming up with a name though. I did brainstorm a little and I came up with Steph Shelf. I don't know, how do we feel about that? If you think it's corny, let me know your suggestions, your ideas. I would love to hear them. And of course, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you soon. Mwah.